Hello everybody and welcome back to the channel. My name is the Prince of FNAF, and if you're new here, please consider subscribing and also be sure to hit that notification bell. That way, you'll indeed be notified for any awesome videos like this in the future. Guys, I finally got my claws on the Jurassic World Dominion Sound Slash and Therizinosaurus from the folks over at Mattel, and this is quite an awesome figure. Given my first dive into the new Dominion line, I gotta say I'm not disappointed with this figure. It is just superbly detailed, and as far as I can tell, is screen accurate. It's really cool, and I gotta say I'm not disappointed with the purchase. But before we get into the actual review, let's quickly take a look at the box. Quickly having a look at the box here, there is a nice render of Rexy. She looks like she's roaring, and we also got some power lines, and a lot of nice golden amber adding to the kind of legacy of the franchise. Considering if it wasn't for the mosquitoes and the amber, we wouldn't have dinosaurs roaming the earth. Alright, so here is the Therizinosaurus. Looking pretty cool. The detail on this thing is just quite crazy. Mattel really went all out for this new Dominion line of figures, and I am not disappointed with the purchase. However, the one thing that I can say might be off is that the beak is not yellowy-orange, and the area around the eyes should be, like, blue. But other than that, this figure is really spot-on as far as what I could see in the commercial that came out a couple months ago. But this thing is just gnarly. The face sculpt, the fur, the feathers, the scales, everything on it is great. They even used a really interesting plastic. People are liking it to marble, which is basically, it's a black plastic with bits of brown into it to kind of give the illusion that this thing has patches of colored feathers. And then on the back you have the feathers, the reddish orange feathers on the back, and they're kind of nicely done, and then they fade into dry brushing, which is really cool. The detail between the feathers and the scales and even the skin is great. They painted the claws and it looks super awesome. No Talon paint, but it's still cool nonetheless. Zooming in on the tail, where some of that feathering really shines, you can just see how much detail they put into Theodore the Therizinosaurus here. Just really good feather and skin detail. It is just spot on. For its gimmick, it does have this really cool striking gimmick, like it's a freaking snake. That's pretty cool. And the noise is really finicky on this figure. It has no visible off switch, so every time the figure is moved even slightly, it'll cause it to shriek and growl, which I guess could be really annoying to parents, and quite frankly, I'm even pondering getting a screwdriver just to unscrew the battery. The second gimmick is this claw-slashing action. Nice, right? You definitely want your Therizinosaurus to be able to slash people. Alright, just for a little size comparison, here is the Sound Slash and Therizinosaurus. Next to our more recent Jurassic Park review, the Jurassic World Heroes of Gujitsu Squishy Blue. And as you can see, compared to Theodore here, he or she is quite precious. And just to give you a range of her size, here is Theodore the Therizinosaurus next to the NECA Gremlins 2 the New Batch Ultimate Greta figure. And you can see that he is pretty big. Now, the reasoning for this is, those of you who don't collect NECA, Greta is about the same size as a regular NECA figure, which makes Theodore the Therizinosaurus here extremely large. And finally, here is Theodore next to the Hot Toys Avengers Endgame Black Widow. And with Black Widow stand, she is nearly the same size as Theodore here, and she was the only figure I had that even stood remotely close to Theodore's height, so I thought I would just include her for fun. Anyway, this figure definitely lived up to my hype. I am just psyched to have it, and this really starts the review season of Jurassic World Dominion out with a bang, and I can't wait to pick up some other figures from the range to review for you guys and for my own enjoyment, because I'm such a huge fan of the franchise. But it is quite a figure, lived up to my hype. The only gripe I would have with it is that there is no visible off button. They had all this time to create a really screen accurate Therizinosaurus figure, but no time to put an off button so you can make this thing shut up. But with that, it is still a great figure, and when I get moved into my new place, whenever that may be, I can't wait to find a great place to put him on display. But let me know what you guys think about this figure if you have it. And with that being said, do take care, have a great night, and I'll see you guys in the next video, whenever that may be.